In this video, we are going to see about a NAND gate. So generally, the NAND and NOR gates are widely used. So we have two gates, which is NAND and NOR gates. These two gates are widely used and are readily available in most integrated circuits. A major reason for the widespread use of these gates is that these both are called as universal gates. So these both are universal gates. So generally universal in the sense that both can be used for AND operators, OR operators as well as inverter. Thus we see that a complex digital system can be completely synthesized using only NAND gates or NOR gates. Now we will see the detail about the NAND gate. The NAND gate is a NOT AND. So the NAND gate is a NOT AND or an inverted AND. So generally NAND gate is nothing but NOT AND or an inverted AND function. And the standard logic symbol for the NAND gate is like it will be like a AND gate with a small bubble like this. So this is the logic symbol for the NAND gate, that is to invert the output of AND. So this is the inputs A, B and this is the output Y. So this can be otherwise written as, drawn as like this, AND gate. These are the inputs and the output of AND gate will be product AB. So if you do the inverter operation, that is inverted AND. So this will be AB whole dash or complement. So this is the figure A shows the NAND gate logic symbol. NAND gate logic symbol. And the figure B shows the a separate AND gate and inverter being used to produce the NAND logic function. And the truth table is like follows. So this is the input. This is the output. So you have inputs A, B. The output of AND and the output of NAND. If suppose inputs are 0, 0, so AND output will be 0. So NAND output will be inverter of that, so it will be 1. If it is 0 and 1, AND output will be 0, again it will be 1. If it is 1, 0, AND output will be 0, it will be 1. If both are 1s, AND output will be 1, this will be 0. So for in a NAND gate, you can observe that. So the output will be high if either of the input is high or both the inputs are low. So output will be low if both the inputs are high. So you can tell that the unique output from the NAND gate is low only when all the inputs are high. When all inputs are high. You can see that the Boolean expression. So A dot B whole bar is equals to the out. So this is the AND symbol. Dot means AND symbol. And this one bar is the NOT symbol. So you can write this as or AB whole bar is equals to Y or AB whole complement. This anything is same. And the logic symbol for this is this is the logic symbol. AND gate with small bubble. So now we will see the NAND gate as a universal gate. So let me draw the table. This is the logic function. And the symbol. And circuit using NAND gates only. Circuit using NAND gates only. So if the logic function is inverter, the symbol for the inverter is this one. If this is the A, the output will be A dash. And how to implement the inverter using the NAND gate only. If this is the taking a bubble, you can get this A dash. And next one is the AND. Logic function is AND. And the symbol for this one is AB. This input is A. Now how to get the AND from the NAND gate? So if you take this one, A, B, you will get AB bar. If you again give this to the one more NAND gate, like this, then it will become AB. Next is OR. This is inputs A, B, so you will get as A plus B. So this is one NAND gate, one more NAND gate, so this is B. Now you will give this A bar and B bar to a NAND gate, so which will become A plus B. So let's see how it becomes. So A bar, B bar, so the output will be whole bar. So if you apply this complementing, so it will become A bar whole bar plus B bar whole bar. So which is equals to A plus B. So this is how you can implement any logic function using only NAND gates. That's why this is called as a universal gate.